While it might be intuitive to think that the cellular response to a particular hormone is entirely dependent upon the concentration of that circulating hormone, that's not entirely true. In fact, receptors are also regulated. We can regulate their numbers or their affinity, the likelihood, the strength with which they bind the particular hormone. So looking first at receptor regulation in terms of numbers, we have up and down regulation here. So in response to high hormone levels, right, we have a large circulating concentration of hormone molecules here, the cellular response would tend to be quite large. However, in response to that, vesicles form where we endocytose membrane-bound receptors, reducing the likelihood of interaction of hormone with those reduced number of receptors. This, of course, reduces the sensitivity of that cell. Now, it might sound like we're sort of canceling out the activity of this high hormone level for which there was a stimulus. However, the end goal here really should be viewed as avoiding an excessively large response to high hormone levels, which can lead to a disease process. Now, just as we had reduced sensitivity to high hormone levels, we can have increased sensitivity to low hormone levels that we see down here. So in this case, vesicle-stored receptors can be exocytosed, added to the membrane, enhancing the likelihood of interaction between this smaller number of hormones and the increased number of receptors. This, of course, increases sensitivity to this particular hormone. Now, changing the receptor numbers was but one mechanism. There are others, not shown here, where we change affinity levels, right? That strength of binding between the hormone and its receptor. And that can happen in response to the hormone that binds that receptor, but it can also happen in response to other hormones. In other words, hormones affecting the affinity of receptors for a different hormone. That creates a complexity in hormonal response where hormones are actually interacting with one another, adjusting sensitivity to other stimuli, cell stimuli. Another mechanism of altering affinity is through local environmental changes like pH or temperature. And finally, we want to think of phosphorylation as another mechanism of sort of turning cellular proteins on and off, and that includes receptors and their ability to bind hormones, right? And so phosphorylation can be a mechanism of activating or deactivating receptors.